What is up? Welcome back to the channel. It is J-Rob here from Team Energy Golf Clash, and we've got yet again another hole here in the Golf Clash library. So, with that being said here, we have the Frosty Peaks tournament right around the corner. So, with Grunberg Slopes being the tournament's featured course here, we're going to be doing our absolute best here to fill out our Grunberg Slopes Golf Clash library playlist for you guys, so you guys have the best possible information here before the tournament. We also owe you guys a huge thank you here because we've now hit a massive milestone on the YouTube channel. We now actually have a new donation link in the top right hand corner of our channel's home page, right next to our team's Facebook groups, which we also encourage you guys to join. We actually have a Golf Clash Library Facebook page as well, dedicated specifically for our Golf Clash Library playlists and our community. So if you'd like to help support our content, one of the best ways you can do so is by smashing that like button, subscribing to the channel, sharing this video with your Golf Clash friends, and being a part of our awesome community. We've got so much more content in store for you guys, so check out our community tab on the channel page, check out our upcoming videos, or leave us a suggestion. I definitely appreciate each and every one of you guys out there watching our content. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with us along the way, but without further ado, let's dive on over to hole number 4, par 4 here for Grunberg Slopes. We really hope this content helps you. Alright guys, what's up? Welcome to the Golf Clash Library Guide for Grunberg Slopes, hole number 4, par 4 here. So we're going to break this down here. We got a couple different, you know, ways that we're going to show you guys here to play this specific hole. Now, I don't want to get into a whole lot of detail right off of the bat because we're really going to get into it here. But the essential way here that we're going to want to play this hole here is one of two different ways, either the right side here or this middle option, depending on the wind that we get. So right there, as you saw, I had a 3.6 mile an hour tailwind going straight away from me. So I chose to, you know, use that left-hand option because I knew it was going to blow me down to where I can make a nice shot there with about 4 to 5 bars of topspin and full right-hand side spin there at 3 bars to the right. And it'll get me down here nice for this short iron shot here to the pin. Now, essentially what this shot's going to be is going to be a mid-distance shot here plus 10%. So what I did is I used 2 bars of backspin there, and I moved my target 5 rings over plus shot. Another ring there for my elevation as well. So I moved that one whole target over plus another yellow ring there at 6 rings. So now let's actually get into, you know, playing an opponent here on this course and really diving in to discuss a lot of these things here. So we have a 10 mile an hour tailwind on the left hand side. Last time we had a 3.6 mile an hour tailwind. So at max distance on my extra mile there, I knew that it was going to blow my ball 3.6 just past the red ring there with elevation. Now on this 10 mile an hour wind, that's going to blow my ball more than what my whole target is with the elevation. So I don't need to use any overpower here whatsoever. Now as you can see, the elevation and his overpower, even with a marlin ball, pushed him way further down into the rough, past almost where that bunker is there. So as you can see, it's going to blow your ball very, very far, and mine would do the exact same thing there even without overpower if I were to just hit my ball there. So I decided to use a quasar ball here and just pull my ball guide back and play it safe here on the right hand side to show you guys here that we also have a very nice long iron shot here to the right that can attack the pin at a decent way as well. So what I did at a 9.5, I moved this one whole target back 5 rings here. We went full top spin and full left-hand side spin here with the quasar ball. And we're just gonna get ourselves down here on this right side platform as much as we can here, because it's gonna set ourselves up here for a nice second shot right at the pin with a grizzly or a Goliath there at either max or mid distance there with your long iron. Or if you don't get down that platform far enough, you will actually have a minimum distance sniper shot about to the pin there as well, which, you know, if you feel more comfortable with that, you know, you may not want to just blast it down that right-hand side and maybe play it a little bit more safe and just take a nice easy drive down the right-hand side, because you definitely will be able to reach, the green no matter what, usually on this hole, as long as you get down there far enough. But as you could see, you know, my opponent was still able to reach there with his Nirvana and his rough iron there. But we're going to jump over here to this shot. As you can see, we're right on this right-hand side there. As you can see, you know, the sniper is just a little bit further up there as soon as we get to the green. And that is because we're further down here. But what we're going to do here is play this with just about a bar and a half of backspin. You know, you could pull it back, you know, even a little bit more, you know, than I pushed it up. You could leave it a little bit further back, like where I had it. But what you're going to do is kind of look for that high arced bounce location. And at 7.6, I was able to move this here, my entire target over. And that is going to account for our elevation and for that 7.6, because at my entire target on that Goliath would have been 8.7. So we came in straight at the pin there, but we just put a little bit too much backspin on. So make sure that, you know, you have just enough backspin to where it's going to continue to roll and go into the pin there. So, you know, with about a bar and a half there would have been perfect. This is definitely going to be one of those holes, especially for the Frosty Peaks tournament. It's going to be a really nice one here to snag an extra stroke and, you know, really one up your opponent there. Maybe snag one of those nice tournament chests as well, which we're going to actually have a video coming out on all of the new tournament chests and, you know, what you should expect from those, because as we know, there's been a new release on those tournament chests. And we get a lot of pretty good items now, and, you know, a lot of multiples as well. But as always here, we are going to have a shootout here at the end of our Golf Clash Library holes. So we have hole number 3 here, par 3, I do believe, here for Grenberg Slopes as well. So how we're going to play this one here is from the second tee box here. We're going to play this one at 20% elevation off of our first shot here. So what we're going to do is play it with about 2.5 bars of topspin, roughly, depending on how far up towards that little hook that comes out in the fairway there. We have that rough line that kind of hooks out. We're going to play it just before that with about a bar of left-hand side spin and 2.5 bars of topspin there. What we're looking for is our ball to double bounce right before the green there, so that it slows our ball down. Actually, it's going to double bounce like right around where the fringe is, because it's going to bounce here, it's going to bounce again, and then it's going to double bounce right there. See how his ball like bounced and kept rolling kind of smoothly? You almost want your ball to bounce and bounce again, and it almost like nicks the green and the fringe there, and it'll stop, and it slows it down just that little bit. That's the ideal approach there. But I know that's not always, you know, 100% accurately to do. So, you know, what we're going to do is just get you as dialed in as we possibly can here. So we're going to leave our ball guide just shy there, just shy of the pin, and we're going to move this here 4.0 just over about to where that rough line is. And then I moved it a little bit more there, as you can see, up that hill for our elevation. And as you can see, I was about 2 rings there into the rough line. So I was playing that at about roughly like 25% or so. So that's why you're going to see us come in here a lot further here to the left than we want to be as well. And as you can see, we didn't hit that double bounce as well, but at 2.5 bars of backspin, that's going to get you very, very close to landing, right around where the pin is. So if you get your wind adjustment there correctly and spot on, you should be very close in a nice hole there to grab a hole in one. So that's going to be a nice tournament hole there for the Frosty Peaks tournament as well. But that's going to be the wrap up here for the video today, guys. Really hope these gave you a good general idea on how to play a couple of these Grunberg Slopes holes here. We are going to have the Frosty Peaks tournament guide video coming out here very soon, as well as another wind and tutorial video and a Tour 9 tips live gameplay video. So definitely stay tuned for that and peep out our new logo that we've uploaded on the community tab. And we will catch you guys in the next video. Peace.